in general, depending on how present a child is, stimming can be very, very bad, very, very harmful, or not terribly significant. You know, we're talking about the autism spectrum. It's a broad range of kids, from kids with, you know, very, very severe disabilities up to people who function well. Primarily looking at those in the lower end of the spectrum, stimming, which is what I generally refer to as debilitating sensory addictive behaviors, is extremely negative. Essentially, what's happening with this stimming is a child's playing with what's underdeveloped or broken in sensory channels. They tend to become addicted to these behaviors. They engage in these behaviors with high frequency, often very, very high intensity, and over extended periods of time, essentially triggering very negative neuroplasticity, negatively impacting their brain. And as with any other addiction, if you have an addiction, your brain tends to focus on that addiction. If we're trying to have a child and assist a child in developing, the last thing we need is their brain consumed with seeking pleasure through their addictions. So stimming, if you will, on the lower end of the spectrum, is extremely dangerous, extremely harmful, and something we want to redirect as much as we can. We don't punish it. The child's not being bad. The child is fulfilling a need, like being hungry. But we want to redirect it and encourage the child to engage in activities, opportunities that are going to stimulate the brain in a positive way, trigger positive neuroplasticity, and contribute to their development.